This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Pie in the Sky is a 25D and 3D first-person shooter engine most popular in the mid to late 1990s by Pie in the Sky Software, also known as Power 3D and the 3D Game Creation or 3D Game Creation System Engine. The engine was used in two games by the company as well as many other independent games and amateur projects after it was turned into a game creator, largely because it minimized the amount of computer programming knowledge needed to make 3D games in its editing tools. Contents 1 History 2 Games 21 Internal Usage 211 Corncob 3D 212 Lethal Tender 213 Terminal Terror 214 Industrial Killers 215 Santis Rescue 3D 216 Max Resistance 217 Cyberpunk 22 DOS Developers 221 Red Babe 222 La Cosa Nostra 223 Despair Series 224 Terror in Christmas Town 225 Deer Napped 226 Castaway, The Ordeal Begins 227 Space Station Escape 228 Continuum 229 Colosso Adventure Series 2210 Freak Software 2211 Chub Gam 3D 23 Windows Developers 231 Pencil Whip 2311 The Tickle People 232 XYLOT's Revenge 233 Prezi Hunt 234 Infiltration 3 References 4 External Links History The company, formed principally by programmer Kevin Stokes, first dabbled in 3D computer graphics by creating a modestly popular TSR 3D screen saver called Intermission in 1987. After more developments, they developed a 3D flight simulator Corncob 3D in 1992. The game was inspired by a flight simulator for the Apple II. The game was first released as shareware and then later commercially as Corncob Deluxe by MVP Software. After seeing Wolfenstein 3D, they wrote a new 3D engine in C and used it in the first-person shooter Lethal Tender in 1993. Based on that, they were hired by a German group to create a German first-person shooter Pie in the Sky released Terminal Terror, the sequel to Lethal Tender. In 1994 the development of this game, to be published by Expert Software, had taken precedence over the German development and thus strained the relationship. The game was relatively successful, but the company sensed they were unable to keep up and stay ahead of other first-person shooter developers. To get around this and enter a niche market, they decided to create the 3D game creation system and market themselves to consumers who wanted to make their own 3D games. It is first used by games such as Red Babe by The Dark Cavern Productions and La Cosa Nostra by Slade 3D Software. In 1995 it was used in the Despair series, Terror in Christmas Town, Deer Napped, and Castaway, The Ordeal Begins. Meanwhile, the various bugs in the program were worked out and upgrades and patches were released, partly because of the rushed development of the system in the first place. The contract with the German group changed, and instead the new game creation system was re-released in German as well as English. The engine was ported to Microsoft Windows and DirectX in 1998, as well as updating it beyond Wolfenstein 3D-like standards. The company had first detected the decline of DOS in 1994, and had decided to port to Windows and adopt 3D API technology using the RenderWare library. This was first attempted in a racing game called Baja Bash, but emphasis was switched to converting the old game creation engine because of market demands, time constraints, and some criticism of the later game. Despite its attempted physics advances because of licensing constraints, however, they eventually opted to use Direct 3D in this updated form that it was used in the game Pencil Whipped, designed for the 2000 Independent Games Festival. Chub Gam 3D, an earlier freeware game, was reissued in Director's Cut form in 1998. In 2001 the third version of the engine was released, featuring true 3D polygonal enemies and weapons, 3D terrain, super lighting effects, and other improvements. The engine ceased being sold in May 2003, and soon after the Pie in the Sky Company website came down. The book 3D Game Creation by Luca Hearn for CyberRookies has a section which examines making games using the Pie in the Sky development tools, and the system, alongside GameMaker, Studio, Construct, The Games Factory and FPS Creator, was used in the Problem Solving Through Game Creation course put out by the College of Engineering and Applied Science in 2010. The company was restarted, and has created a physics engine demo and a DICE simulation for the Android operating system, tested on the Motorola Droid. The choice of a physics engine is likely inspired by the popularity of the corncob 3D physics. The company's new website notes the focus will be more about making fun stuff than being a money-producing business. The rebirth of the company was inspired by a feeling that small companies can make a better headway in the mobile market than on the PC market, based on their struggling experience trying to keep the pie in the sky tools current to big-name standards in the 1990s. Games internal usage. Pie in the Sky Software made several games on the engine and its predecessors, first its own shareware products and later examples for the game creation system. Corncob 3D. The Pie in the Sky engine's popular predecessor game, instead of being a first-person shooter like the later games based on Pie in the Sky, it is a flight simulator game. The game takes place in a world where Hitler died in childhood and World War II never happened. In its stead, aliens have invaded the Earth. The player must take control of a F-4U Corsair, the only World War II plane that made it into this alternate history, and defeat the alien invaders. The game takes place in a variety of different locations and was noted for its original gameplay and presentation. It is also known for being one of the few shareware flight simulators. Computer Gaming World's reviewer, a United States Army Aviation Branch pilot, stated that Corncob 3D delivers one of the best attempts at a VR-like living environment in a flight sim so far. He praised the total virtual freedom in the game world, the smooth animation, compatibility with lower-end computers, and believable flight models, while criticizing the lack of terrain features, air-to-air combat, and limited control options. The reviewer concluded that Corncob 3D offers some new ideas that will certainly be seen in future games. With a high price challenge fun ratio, lethal tender secret agent Nick Hunter must thwart the evil Thorn Devereaux, who is planting bombs in U.S. currency. The game featured various singular features such as taking the uniforms of dead enemies for protection. The game is described by Home of the Underdogs as a fun, albeit amateurish, first-person shooter. The game set out the style followed closely by most other Pie in the Sky engine games, particularly noting its inventory system, though even its graphics were mostly reused by later games as well. The game is also known as Legal Tender Terminal Terror. Pie in the Sky Software's sequel to Lethal Tender. The game featured an expanded array of features, including early examples of the stealth gameplay of later games like Thief. The player is again Nick Hunter, with a mission to take back into custody the international terrorist Bruno Riggs, who has fortified himself and his men in a captured Air Force base with several hostages, including Hunter's fiancé. Abandonia compared it to System Shock in that it was ahead of its time, referencing its new features such as friendly non-playable characters and damage varying based on where hit. The game was published by Expert Software Industrial Killers, an example game made in 1995 to demonstrate the original DOS version, and takes the form of a short game featuring giant killer bugs. In particular, it shows off the engine's outdoors capability. Within its large first level included were various notes and promotions for the game creation system Santa's Rescue 3D, a Christmas-themed example featuring an alternative sprite set to match the theme, as well as nonviolent play. This formed the basis of both Dear Napt and Terror in Christmas Town. Max Resistance. Max Resistance was an example game from the company website that was released to promote the final version of the game creation system, to showcase both its gameplay and graphical abilities, particularly 3D terrain and models. It was also made quickly and cheaply, to show the relative quality that could be made easily with the tool. The story involves a man named Max taking up arms against an alien invasion. Cyberpunk, although not created by Pie in the Sky Software, the early release date of this title and its extensive modification from the base engine indicate that this game was produced through license from Pie and not through the GCS. This is most shown by its genre. Rather than being a first-person shooter, it is a first-person racing sports game, a remake of the older Ball Blaster game for the Apple II. It was developed by Dungeon Entertainment, Webfoot Technology, and published by Homebrew Software, Ticksoft, and released in 1992. It is also known as 3D Cyberpunk, 3D Cyber Blaster and 3D Ball Blaster. It is described as a mixture between soccer and hockey, with a wide variety of objects and power-ups available for use, played between two hovercraft in a time when such sports have replaced violence. DOS developers. The majority of games were made in the first version of the game creation system, which was released for DOS. Red Babe. Red Babe was one of the first games to use the Pi in the Sky engine that was not made by the engine creators themselves, being made by the Dark Cavern Productions. The game features the player's quest to save the beautiful Sharla, the titular Red Babe. Because of her penchant for a red dress, future versions were to become a 30-level intricate 3D game, and an adult fantasy type with nudity. La Cosa Nostra, a mobster-themed first-person shooter game using the Pi in the Sky engine. The player takes the role of NYPD investigator Slade A. Riker, who must stop the crime boss Joribaldi and his gang after they murdered his partner, brother-in-law, and now hold his wife hostage. It was included on at least one shareware compilation containing the first episode of the game. The second level of the first episode's level track is the theme from the film The Terminator, hinting the soundtrack comprises various MIDI files found on the internet, though the game's variety in terms of textures, graphics and sounds is more than most Pi in the Sky engine games. The game was developed by Tony L. Ford under the group title of Slade 3D Software. Despair series. The entire Despair trilogy use the Pi in the Sky engine. All games feature a battle with aliens, with the third game featuring a wind machine threatening Earth. The games were developed by Unique Software. Terror in Christmas Town, a Christmas-themed first-person shooter, featuring the player having to rescue Santa Claus from a polar bear. The game was created by Michael Zerbo and released in 1995. The demo version of the game is still available for free as shareware, though the full version had to be purchased by sending $10 directly to Michael Zerbo. Dear Napped. Like Terror in Christmas Town, this game features a Christmas theme. The player is a ninja working for Santa and must rescue his reindeer from the abominable snowpeople. The game was created by Nick Ty Entertainment Tick, which consisted of Nick Fletcher and Tyler Smith of Smith's Falls, Ontario, who were both only age 14 at the time of the game's release. The game was made while participating in a program called I Want to Be a Millionaire. The aim of the program was to encourage young entrepreneurs to learn about business through hands-on experience. The game is notably non-violent, as enemies are turned into harmless snowmen rather than dying castaway. The ordeal begins. A game by John T. Gallen that features the player landing on a foreign planet, and must proceed to shoot his way through the game. The backstory describes the results of the Slurian War, and how the Terran Stellar Union had failed to defend its lush terraformed planets, and the practice of cloning human prisoners to conquer more Terran worlds unbreathable to them and make up for their low birthrate, probably to accommodate the default human sprite. Space Station Escape, a release by RB Soft. Roy L. Person Sr. In 1995, Space Station Escape is a science fiction game wherein the player has face an alien attack of a space station, one of the last bastions of humanity following Earth's recent destruction. The majority of the enemies in the game are either reprogrammed defense systems or cloned humans made by the aliens to compensate for their low birthrate, probably a concession to the human-like guard sprites that came with the editor. The game centers around releasing the ship's imprisoned crew and either disarm the self-destruct sequence or escape in time. The shareware level contains five levels. Continuum is a plot-focused title with more of an emphasis on free exploration than shooting, released in 1996 through 1997 by Wales. Innovative scripting and interactivity features premiered in Terminal Terror, as well as an accompanying paper titled Continuum, an Odyssey of Creation. The game received numerous positive comments, including from Kevin Stokes, and comparisons were drawn to early plot-oriented first-person games such as Strife, as well as numerous statements raising it above the average GCS-produced game. The game's heavy plot focus on a secret CIA project at Area 51 into the space-time continuum headed by Section 7, using recovered alien technology, that now threatens the fabric of the universe itself. Desperate, a prominent and now disillusioned project member, Dr. Richard Golchin, recruits the son of his old friend and collaborator to infiltrate the project in the hopes of exposing and ending it. Colosso Adventure Series. The Colosso Adventure Series is a trilogy of games by Campana Productions' Tom Campana made with the engine, with the first part released in April 1996 based on a childhood dream of creating computer games. The author based his design on his likes and dislikes from mainstream games of the time. The first episode, Escape from Dr. Colosso, was released in December and follows the efforts of man to rescue the kidnapped Red Princess from the vile Dr. Colosso and his legion of henchmen and monsters. Episode 2, Colosso Revenge, takes place after the events of the first game and features the quest to deactivate Colosso's creating machine. Finally, Episode 3, Colosso Secret, involves the attempt to rid the world of Colosso's Mutants back through their time gates. All three episodes were packaged together as the Colosso Value Pack as well, and the series marks an early incarnation of the episodic game model a successor series was worked on, utilizing a later version of Pi 3D, but only tests and betas were ever released. Freak Software in 1996, Freak Software comprising Gary Wilson and Michael Wilford released two titles using the engine The Maze. Does not have a stated plot, the shareware level featured four levels, and the registered version 20 Secret Agent. Windows developers versions 20, released in 1998, and 30, released in 2001, were made for Microsoft Windows and featured much more advanced options. Pencil Whipped, released in 2001, might be the most well-known of the Pie in the Sky games and one of the only ones to utilize a later version of the engine. The game won developer Lonnie Flickener, aka Chiselbrain Software, a chance at the $15,000 Summa's McNally Grand Prize and awards for technical excellence, game design, visual art, and audio based on a strange dream Flickener had. The game became known for its unique black and white pencil drawn world and for its wider novelty value, being described by Wirecom as like being trapped inside a very disturbed child's drawing. In 2006, work was done towards a sequel on using the game creator's tools, and more recently work has been done on an iPhone remake called Escape from Big Ass Castle, which was originally released in 2012 for iOS 6 on the iPhone, but has been taken off of the market to be redone for the iOS 7. The Tickle People, a previous game by Chiselbrain Software that served as Lonnie Flickener's educational project, released in 2000. The plot involved an accident with a supercomputer that led to all the nearby workers being absorbed inside its strange artificial environments. A demo version was released, but the final game was never completed, as with Pencil Whipped. A more modern remake was attempted. XYLOT's Revenge was developed by Somewhere in the Dark USA Sidusa, featuring an eclectic mixing of modern, fantasy and science fiction themes. The premise is that 20 years after defeating the half-machine Xylet and recovering the Medallion of Creation, the people of Xyles learn that the villain has returned and recaptured the medallion within his tomb. Cooter, head of the Elders, sends Ephradius, the original challenger of Xylet, to face him once again. Prezi Hunt, made by Skyline Software, is a free multi-award winning Christmas game that is still supported and has a new level added each holiday season. The game is easy to play, and unlike most FPS games, it doesn't involve weapons or fighting. The player has to explore a winter world made up of large levels inhabited by dancing snowmen, penguins and helpful fairies, collecting presents and solving puzzles. Infiltration, also made by Skyline Software. Infiltration is a classic FPS where the player has to infiltrate the Umbra Corporation to find and steal a mainframe disk and also try to find out what happened to another agent who was sent in before. The game is set over 29 levels, but there is only a two-level demo available for download. The pages relating to the game have not been updated recently, but the author doesn't confirm the game has been shelved. There are plenty of screenshots to suggest there is a lot more of this game than the two demo levels references. Carrot, year 1995. 3D Shooter Legends 3DSL game. Hostorg, retrieved the 25th of August 2011. Carrot Pi 3D Physics Demo V10 Andralibcom. Carrot About Pi in the Sky Software, the 13th of March 2010, retrieved the 25th of August 2011. Carrot Industrial Killers Arcades 3D. Carrot Santa's Rescue Pi in the Sky Software. Carrot Max Resistance Marketer's Pantry, archived April 2, 2012, at the Wayback Machine. Carrot Max Resistance Free Download Center. Carrot 3D Cyberpunk. Carrot 3D Cyberpunk MS-DOS Game MS-DOS Games Info. Carrot Red Babe 3D Shootmaster, retrieved the 25th of August 2011. Carrot IIS, Continuum. Carrot IIS, PC, Continuum Commons. Carrot Continuum 3D Shooter Legends. Carrot Escape from Dr. Colosso, GameWorld Network. Carrot Colosso Adventure Series, Campana Productions. Carrot Campana Productions Shareware Files. Carrot GAMEAR 3D RCD, Text Filescom. Carrot Chub Gam 3D, DSK Games. DSK Games Tripodcom, the 7th of August 2001, retrieved the 25th of August 2011. Carrot Hori Gori, Pencil Whip 2 Chiselbrain Software. Carrot Pencil Whipped Escape from the Tickle People GameSalad Dead Link. Carrot Tickle People Demo Gamers Hell. Carrot The Tickle People Demo FilePlanet. Carrot The Tickle People Remake. Carrot Welcome to the Revenge of XYLOT Sidusa. Carrot Prezi Hunt Skyline Software. Carrot Infiltration Skyline Software. External links: New Pi in the Sky Software website, Pi in the Sky engine on MobyGames, Pi in the Sky Software at ModBGCS Archives, GCS Games G2 website GCS Max YouTube playlist. VE Game Engines List Source Port First Person Shooter Engine List Tile Engine Game Engine Recreation List Game Creation System Free and Open Source 2D Adventure Game Studio Beats of Rage Cocos 2D Flixel Joker Kirikiri Lib GDX Moai OHRRP GCE Open FLORX Pygame Renpi Strategus 1000 Parsec Vassal XCONQ 25D Aleph 1 Cube 3D Away 3D Blender Game CAFU Crystal Space Cube 2 Delta 3D Dim 3 GU Create Glycine Horde 3D HPL 1 Earlicht Id Tech 3 Id Tech 4 J Monkey Ogre Open Wonderland Panda 3D Papervision 3D Platinum Art Sandbox Free 3D Game Maker PlayCanvas PLIB Quake Quake 2 RealmForge Retribution Torque 3D Mix Allegro Construct Classic Godot Lightweight Java Game Library Spring Wintermute Engine Proprietary 2D Construct 2 Corona ClickTeam Fusion GameMaker, Studio GameSalad Muggin End Scripter RPG Maker Southpaw Stencil Ubiart Framework Vicious Virtual Theater V Play Zillions of Games 3D 4A Amazon Lumberyard Anvil Bork 3D C4 Chrome Clausewitz Engine Creation CryEngine Crystal Tools Diesel Dunia EAGL Ego Elflight Enforce Enigma Essence Flare 3D Fox Frostbite Geo Mod Gold's RC Hero Engine HydroEngine HPL 2-3 Id Tech 5 Id Tech 6 Ignite IW Jade Kinetica LS 3D Lithtech Luminous Studio Lin Marmalade Mizuchi Mount Framework Outera Panta Ray FieryEngine Q Real Virtuality Redengine Refractor Riot Rage Sage Sirius Shark 3D Shiva Silent Storm Source Titan Toshi TrueVision 3D Unigen Unity Unreal Vision Visual 3D XN Gine X-Ray Yeti Zero Mix Gamebryo Hybrid Graphics Kineva Game Platform Metismo Historical Interest Brender Build Dark Doom Game Maker GameMaker Gary Kitchens GameMaker Genesis 3D Genie Filmation Freescape Insane Jedi Made Pie in the Sky Renderware Sim RPG Maker Sith Voxel Space Wolfenstein 3D Proprietary Middleware List Euphoria Gameware Gameworks Havoc iMuse Kinaps Quazzle Speedtree Zaitment FaceGen